Well, this weekend is put up or shut up time for Pauline Hanson's One Nation Party. The polls in Queensland are indicating that One Nation could take up to 4 seats. A strong performance up north is vital if One Nation is to take hold in Victoria. When I spoke to Robin Spencer, the Victorian convener of One Nation last week, she told us that they would be fielding candidates here in at least 15 federal seats. One person who should know whether One Nation has both the structure and the political savvy to succeed here is Pauline Hanson's former political adviser, John Pascarelli. Tony Le-Nguyen is worried she might succeed. Mr. Le-Nguyen fled Vietnam in a boat 20 years ago. Now an actor, he played the gang leader in Romper Stomper, and he sees One Nation as racist. Mr. Pascarelli, if I could start with you, how many seats do you think One Nation will win, and what impact will it have on the political landscape?
Cathy, from this distance, she certainly looks like if she's going to win more than one seat, and that's going to be an incredible performance, because what it means is that One Nation is going to outpoll what the DLP and the Democrats polled at their first attempt at an election. And even if she didn't win one seat and did that, that would be an incredible result. The fact that she's going to get seats is mind-boggling.
Well, what impact?
Particularly for her opposition.
What impact do you think that's going to have in Victoria?
Well, it's going to have an impact on the whole of Australia, and particularly Victoria, because what it means is that One Nation will do to the coalition what the DLP did to the Labor Party. And, I mean, that's enough to send either sides of politics, you know, straight off to the local hotel.
What do you and you mean that it will divide them and reduce their power electorally?
That's right, and One Nation can say, look, do what we... modify your policies to placate the Hansonites, or we keep you out of office. And they can say that at the moment to both sides. I mean, it's a revenge vote we're going to see in Queensland and other parts of the state. We're going to see it here in Victoria. There was a very interesting example of this at the Constitutional Convention when Mr. Eric Bullimore polled as well in the western suburbs of Melbourne as he did in Colac and Shepparton. Mm. And that's good news for One Nation.
Tony Le-Nguyen, is that good news for you and other non-Australians not born here?
I think Pauline Hanson's very brave. She's probably coming out and doing things that it's already been there always. And, you know, I think that's a very brave move of her to do what she's doing with One Nation. My concern is, you know, Romper Stomper was just a film. And if there are people in our society that act like the characters in Romper Stomper, then there'll be a reaction from the community. And whether that's from the Vietnamese community or from the Aboriginal community, I think if the Vietnamese people who are here trying to resettle and trying to restart their life again, and if there's people who come in trying to disrupt that or take away things that they've worked so hard to start, then there'll be a reaction.
Well, what do you... Sorry, John.
Yeah, well, Tony, I'd just like to remind Tony, he's talking about Romper Stomper. 1997, Tony saw Pauline Hanson's meetings disrupted with a lot of violence. And unfortunately, there were visions of Asian young people and Aboriginal people. And a chap called Warburton was badly beaten up. And I've never seen any of Hanson's supporters react or fight back, as it were. And those images of 1997 just contradict what you've just said. I mean, the criminal behaviour that was there for all of us to see on the television screen is very unsettling and very un-Australian.
Tony, do you think it's going to be a threat to Asian-born Australians if One Nation does take a political hold?
Well, I think if I was a Vietnamese young person who was born in Australia, I have as much right to be an Australian as Pauline Hanson. And if for someone to come to me and tell me that I don't belong here, I'm going to get pretty upset and angry. And that's the sort of young people that I work with, and I'm concerned about that.
Are you saying that's happening to them?
Well, that's the message they're getting at the moment. You know, I mean, people like Pauline Hanson can't tell a difference between, you know, Australian-born Vietnamese and Vietnamese who came over from Vietnam. And I think that's a problem.
Mr. Pascarelli, speaking of problems, you were sacked by Pauline Hanson. You had a major falling out. It sounds as though you've jumped on the bandwagon again.
Well, it's not on the bandwagon. I was pushed off the bandwagon. I've got a lot of personal problems with Pauline Hanson, but I have to put them to one side. and I've got to be objective about it. It's just unfortunate that what happened, from my point of view, happened. I'd certainly like to be up there now, but because this is, if you surely can understand it now, Catherine, I think the media have finally twigged that this is nationwide and it's really applicable. We're in Victoria. Mr. Kennett is trying to be very dismissive. Why does he spend a half an hour on a talkback station doing nothing but bagging Hanson? Why is he suddenly spending a lot of taxpayers' money in Victoria with this new ad on multiculturalism that we're seeing in recent days? He has big problems in the bush. He knows that, and that's why they're all battening down the hatches. This tomorrow should see the beginning of a new revolution in Australian politics. I think it's good. I think we should all get out there and bring these things out into the open without one group saying to people, sit down, shut up, don't talk about this, you're racist, you're a bigot. No, let's finish with all that. Let's be quite open. I think the more open we are, the less chance we'll have of the violence that Tony's trying to allude to, which I think is very incorrect.
Well, John, can I ask you a question? Because yeah. you said somewhere some time ago that you've been DWOG.
That's right.
How did that happen?
By being born in Brisbane. I mean, that was a comment, if you might remember, was made by a National Party member during the last election. He said naturalisation ceremonies were de-wogging ceremonies. Mm. I mean, look, we're all getting very serious. I think a sense of humour is a very healthy thing. Have you ever read a book called You're a Weird Mob?
I'd just like to ask, Tony, what were you aiming at with that question?
Oh, you know, I mean, John said that he's been de-wogged and it's okay for John to make certain comments about...
That's right, I think it's time. I mean, I'm taking the mickey out of people. If people can't stand that. I mean, this is all about humour.
That's why
I want to know that, because a lot of young Vietnamese that I work with want to know how you get de-wogged. You know?
But also, if there's a more serious point too, and that is that if you say it's humour, Tony, do you and the young people you work with accept that it's humorous?
In what way?
Well, I suppose what I'm asking is, if somebody makes a comment like that toward an Asian-born Australian, do you and the young people you work with say, oh, yes, that is funny, or is it an insult? Is it that the comments that are being directed in one level are actually being received in another?
I don't know. It depends on how. I mean, if John's not comfortable with his Italian origin, then
I'm perfectly comfortable with being an Australian, Tony.
You know, I mean, I'm comfortable being Australian.
Yeah, right.
Are you comfortable being an Australian if One Nation takes a political foothold?
Look, what I'm saying is that I think because we're living in a democracy, and Pauline have every single right to do whatever she wants to do, okay. But if she's going around and provoking sort of racial hatred,
she's not provoking racial hatred.
Do you feel that she is?
I think she is.
How has she done that?
Oh, do you know, I mean, the fact that basically blaming Vietnamese young people and saying that they're involved in gang and crime...
Well, Tony, you've got to cop that. I was very angry. I was in New Guinea at the time when Italians were involved a lot in the drug industry up in the Riverina.
I'll just interrupt you there, John. We're actually running out of time.
Okay.
I wanted to let Tony finish his point.
Yeah, I meant everybody's involved in a gang. You know, One Nation is a gang. Labor's a gang. No. It's just Vietnamese young people haven't been able to actually register their name yet. You know, it's just the way you call that.
And on that note, we'll have to leave it. Tony Le-Nguyen and John Prescarelli, thanks very much for your time today.
Thank you.